Good evening to you, Michelle. According to police, both men are victims. Both men are suspects. Coke reportedly has a broken nose and a black eye. Pepsi was pushed, and both are facing charges in what state police are calling an assault.
Coke or Pepsi? Well, it's a matter of taste. But police say it's also a rivalry that turned violent outside the Walmart in Indiana. They tell us drivers from Coke and Pepsi were there delivering their products when a verbal argument escalated and more. Each claims the other tried to run him over with pallets full of pop.
As the victim left the store, then the suspect came over and got into a physical confrontation with him and struck him a few times.
Police suspect the Coke guy of pushing and the Pepsi guy of blowing his top, throwing at least two pops over pop.
He hit him in the face, gave him a black eye, and apparently broke his nose.
The throwdown may be a first, but both companies regularly spend millions of dollars a year duking it out with competing advertising campaigns.
Coke.
Why?
Just tastes better.
I'm going to have to say Pepsi.
The owner of Cook's Market in Greensburg says most of the folks there like Pepsi better, with nearly 75% of the market share. But nationally, Coke is number one, which makes the competition over shelf space fierce.
Most places have to pay premium prices for each lineal foot of shelf space, especially in when you get into the frozen food, the beverages, and the cigarette companies.
Coke would only say their guy is doing okay after the fight. Pepsi says their man has been canned.
That's right, they canned, terminated 42-year-old David Paulina of Clymer because Pepsi says they don't tolerate violence in the workplace. Although police say he and the Coke driver, 48-year-old Robert Cosho of Evansburg, are both considered to be victims. Live in Westmoreland County, I'm Jennifer Mealy, Channel 4 Action News.